vatsapadam bhavabhim Vayam bhujaksha khila sattva dhamni Samadhina besita cheta saike Tvat pada pote namahatvitena Urvanti govatsapadam bhavabhim
Matajis. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, S.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada ki. Tvai in you. Ambujaksha, O lotus-eyed Lord. Akhila sattva dhamni. Who are the original cause of all existence? From whom everything emanates, and in whom all potencies reside? Samadhina, by constant meditation and complete absorption in thoughts of you, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Aveshita, fully absorbed, fully engaged. Chetasa, but by such a mentality. Eke, the one process of always thinking of your lotus feet. Tvatpadapotena, by boarding such a boat as your lotus feet. Mahatkritena, by that action which is considered the most powerful original existence or which is executed by Mahajanas. Kurvanti, they make. Govatsapadam, like the hoof print of a calf. Bhava Abdhim, the great ocean of nescience. Translation. O lotus-eyed Lord, by concentrating one's meditation on your lotus feet, which are the reservoir of all existence, and by accepting those lotus feet as the boat by which to cross the ocean of nescience, one follows in the footsteps of Mahajanas, great saints, sages and devotees. By this simple process, one can cross the ocean of nescience as easily as one can step over the hoof print of a calf. Purport. The true mission in life is to cross the ocean of nescience, of repeated birth and death. Those in the darkness of ignorance, however, do not know this mission. Instead, being carried away by the waves of material nature, prakritih kriyamanani gunahi karmani sarvasah, they are undergoing the tribulations of mrityu samsara vartmani, repeated birth and death. But persons who have achieved knowledge by the association of devotees follow the Mahajanas Mahatkritena. Such a person always concentrates his mind upon the lotus feet of the Lord and executes one or more of the nine varieties of devotional service. Sravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pada Sevanam. Simply by this process, one can cross the insurmountable ocean of nescience. Devotional service is powerful in any form. Sri Vishnu Sravane Parikshit Abhavad Vyasaki Kirtane Bhaktir Samto Sindhu. According to this verse, Maharaj Parikshit became liberated by fully concentrating his mind on hearing the Lord's holy name, attributes and pastimes. Similarly, Sukadeva Goswami simply glorified the Lord, and by speaking on the subject matters of Krishna that constitute the entire Srimad Bhagavatam, he too was liberated. One may also be liberated simply by sakya, friendly behavior with the Lord. Such is the power of devotional service, as we learn from the examples set by the Lord's many pure devotees. Swayambhur Narada Sambhu Kumara Kapilo Manu Prahlado Janako Bhismo Balir Vyasakir Bayam. We have to follow in the footsteps of such devotees, for by this one easy process, one can cross the great ocean of nescience, just as one might cross a small hole created by the hoof of a calf. Here the Lord is described as Ambujaksha, or lotus-eyed, by seeing the eyes of the Lord, which are compared to lotus flowers, one becomes so satisfied that one does not want to turn his eyes to anything else. Simply by seeing the transcendental form of the Lord, a devotee is at once fully absorbed in the Lord in his heart. This absorption is called samadhi. Dhyanavasthita tadgatena manasa pasyanti jam yoginah. A yogi is fully absorbed in thoughts of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, for he has no other business than to think of the Lord always within the heart. It is also said, samasritaje padapallava plavam mahat padam punya jaso murarehe bhavam budhir vatsa padam param padam 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 jad vipadam notesham. For one who has accepted the boat of the lotus feet of the Lord, who is the shelter of the cosmic manifestation and is famous as Murari, the enemy of the demon Mura, the ocean of the material world is like the water contained in a calf's footprint. His goal is Parampadam or Vaikuntha, the place where there are no material miseries, not the place where there is danger at every step. This process is recommended here by authorities like Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva, Swayambhu, Narada Sambhu, and therefore we must take to this process in order to transcend nisayans. This is very easy, but we must follow in the footsteps of great personalities, and then success will be possible. In regard to the word mahatkritena, it is also significant that the process shown by great devotees is not only for them, but also for others. If things are made easy, this affords facility for the person who has made them easy, and also for others who follow the same principles. The process recommended in this verse for crossing the ocean of nisayans is easy not only for the devotee, but also for common persons who follow the devotee, Mahajano Jena Gata Sapantha. Text number 29. Bibharsi rupanya babodho atma kshemaya lokasya characharasya satvopapannani sukhabhani satam bhadrani muhukhalanam. O Lord, you are always in full knowledge, and to bring all good fortune to all living entities, you appear in different incarnations, all of them transcendental to the material creation. When you appear in these incarnations, you are pleasing to the pious and religious devotees, but for non-devotees, you are the annihilator. Purport. This verse explains why the Supreme Personality of Godhead appears as an incarnation again and again. The incarnations of the Supreme Personality of Godhead all function differently, but their main purpose is paritranaya sadhunam vinasaya chaduskritam, to protect the devotees and annihilate the miscreants. Yet, even though the duskritis or miscreants are annihilated, this is ultimately good for them. So, in this section of Srimad Bhagavatam, we are listening the prayers by the demigods. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, now has come in the womb of Mother Devaki. So, demigods, they are taking this wonderful opportunity to offer their prayers in glorification of the Supreme Lord. So, when these demigods are offering their prayers like this, we have heard before how he has been described as he is the original cause of everything and everything emanates from him, and he is the protector of all. So, when they are offering such prayers to the Supreme Lord, then the Lord, who is in the womb of Mother Devaki, like a little one, if he asks this question, "Oh, my dear demigods, you are great souls, you are all knowledgeable persons, I don't understand, why are you offering such kind of prayers to somebody like me, who is in the womb of a mother like Devaki? I am a small boy, why are you offering such prayers to me? Huh? It doesn't make any sense. You are all big, big people, all jnanis. Why are you offering such prayers to me? Then, in response to that, the demigods, they are speaking. That means demigods, when they offer prayer to the Supreme Lord, they are in full knowledge about the position of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Even though he has come in the womb of Devaki, manifesting his pastime as a little boy, but he is non-different from our worshipful Lord, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So, responding to the Lord's question, they are speaking, Bhivarsi Rupani Ababodha Atma. You are not like any other Atma, any other soul who is entering into the womb of his mother to take birth in this material world to pay back his loan, what he has created in the past life. You are not like that. Vibharsi Rupani. In fact, you are the source of all incarnations. You actually execute many incarnations such as Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Rama, etc. All these incarnations are coming from you. You are the Mula. Here it is said, Bivarsi, Loko Sistring Pratidhatse. Even they are saying that when they are addressing the Lord, Bivarsi Rupani Ababodha Atma, they are in their mind thinking, "Oh, you from whom Karana Dakshai Vishnu appears and who actually creates this universe. Who is the Mula, who is the origin, the root of the creation? That's you. From you, everything emanates. And all these incarnations, Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, etc., they also come from you. And when you come, Kshemaya Lokasya, Characharasya, that Kshemaya, Palanaya, for the benefit of everyone. When Lord comes to this world, it's not that when he is killing the demons, he is the enemy of the demons, and he protects those who practice religious principles, and he is their friend. No, Kshemaya, Palanaya. He actually benefits everyone. Everybody is benefited. Srila Prabhupada, he writes in his purport, the last sentence, "Yet, even though the duskritis or miscreants are annihilated, this is ultimately good for them." So he is actually benefiting everyone. And for devotees especially, he has got special thing to offer. Actually, devotees are like, they are very dear to the Lord. Devotees who are engaged 100% in the service of the Supreme Lord, they are very dear to the Lord. So, in general, he is bringing benefit for everyone, but for the devotees, what does he do? Na kevalam palanartham, not that he is coming here, he is appearing in this material world to benefit those who are practicing religious principles, but what he is doing, he is manifesting some forms, he is manifesting some pastimes by assuming a particular form where he gives the opportunity to his devotees to take a deep dive into such pastimes and enter into the stage of samadhi, samadhi yoga. When Krishna, he came and he performed these pastimes we have seen, what he is doing actually? Sva anubhava ananda avesam, avesartham. Sva anubhava ananda avesa. Avesa means one who is constantly thinking about a particular pastime of the Lord, the activity of the Lord, the action, the words which have been spoken by the Lord. That's called avesa. So ananda avesa. Actually, a devotee who sincerely serves the Lord and he identifies with the pastimes of the Lord, then he can come to such a situation wherein he cannot but sustain his existence without thinking about the Lord. And by such thinking, a pure devotee of the Lord, he always swims in transcendental ecstasy. So that is what Lord is trying to give to his devotees. We have seen in the pastime of Krishna, like for example, if you take the example of Krishna lifting Govardhan Hill. Krishna, he lifted Govardhan Hill in a very small age. And all the devotees, Brajvasis, they came under the Govardhan and they were enjoying this pastime. They're looking at him. And many other pastimes he performed. And then later on you can see when Krishna, he performed this, he actually called these gopis to perform rasa dance on the bank of Jamuna. And what happened? After he called them, then he disappeared. Right? Then when Krishna disappears, and from the rasa dance, and the gopis, they started searching for Krishna. And when they could not find Krishna, finally, they gathered on the bank of Jamuna. That time you see the situation of the gopis. Kalindya Krishna Bhavana. That is Krishna Bhavana. It is said that they were imitating Krishna's pastimes. That is what it is. Krishna gives the opportunity. Swa ananda anubhava avesam api. Rupam viharse. So he comes in a particular form and he performs some pastimes where he gives an opportunity to devotees even to become fully absorbed in Krishna. What did gopis do at that time? They were simply remembering the pastimes, how Krishna lifted Govardhan Hill, how Krishna killed Putana, Bakasur. All these pastimes, gopis, they started to enact. This is a high-level devotion, of course. So, in that way, the demigod, they're saying, that's why, Bihursi Rupani Abhavodhatma. You are Abhavodhatma, Jnana Swarupa Vigraha. Means, when he appears in Matsya avatar, Kurma avatar, Nrsimha avatar, some people, they say like, Baraha and others, like, animal incarnation. Why you say him is animal incarnation? He is not animal. Even though he is, looking like an animal, don't tell him he is an animal. Here it is said, Abhavodhatma, Jnana Swarupa. He is fully conscious of his position as the Supreme Lord. And Abhavodha, actually he is fully in his swarupa, knowledge. And the material knowledge cannot reach him. Nobody can understand him by cultivating material knowledge. And how to understand him? Prema rasa. He is actually prema rasa. Not that by studying some shastra, by doing some philosophical research, one can understand him. He is prema rasa. That's why in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, in the beginning, Rupa Goswami says, Akhila Rasamrita Murti. Akhila, it's a very nice term, how he is kind of establishing Krishna. Akhila Rasamrita Murti Prasima Ruchi Ruddha Tara Kapali. Kalita Syama Lalita Radha Prayan Vidhur Jayati. Especially in the first part, he is saying, Akhila Rasamrita Murti. Krishna is the embodiment of all rasas. Not that in some percentage, no. Full, incomplete. His embodiment of complete 12 rasas. So in that way, to understand him, one has to understand him through prema rasa. So that kind of avabodha atma, you are not like an ordinary soul coming in the womb of some mother. The demigods, they understand this. Khimaya lokashtaraj, sattvopapannani sukha bahane, suddha sattva sarupani. Even though he comes in form of matsya kurma braha, still that is suddha sattva sarupa. Suddha sattva sarupa. We have seen Lord, he in his fish incarnation, when he came in the hand of Satyavrata, he started speaking, oh my dear king, from now, in 7 day time, there will be inundation. And whole universe will be inundated with the water of devastation. And at that time, I will appear. And you board the boat with all these bijas and rishis. And then you tie the thread in my horn. And I will be floating in the water of devastation. That's how I'll protect. See? Even though he is in fish form, but he is speaking. He is in full knowledge. He is in full knowledge of his swarupa. That's why, satam abhadrani muhu khalanam. And he actually benefits everyone. So in that way, then the next verse, the demigods, they are praying to the Lord that so far, they have been glorifying the Lord that he comes to protect the pious and chastise the miscreants. Then now he's speaking about his devotees. How he takes care of his devotees, how he protects his devotees is especially stressed in text number 30. Toyambu jakshakra sattva dhamni samadhi navishita chita saiki tatpadapotena mahatkritena kurvanti govatsa padam bhavabdhim. Very nice verse. Toi ambuja akhila sattva dhamni. They are saying that every word Prabhupada is very nicely actually explained in his purport. The devotees of the Lord, they constantly think of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That's called Samadhi Yoga. Samadhi Yoga. What is that Samadhi Yoga? Shastra says, Ayam tu paramo dharma jajyogena atmadarsanam. That constant remembrance of the Supreme Lord, or the constant thinking about the name, form, qualities, and pastimes of the Supreme Lord is Samadhi Yoga. That Samadhi Yoga helps one to personally see the Lord in person. That is Paramadharma. That by practicing such yoga, such meditation, one can see the Lord in person through his eyes.
That is what it has been said here. Ambujaksha. Lord has been addressed here as Ambujaksha. Ambujaksha means, here Prabhupada translate, oh, lotus-eyed Lord. Sometimes we say, oh, Lord's eye is like lotus. Well, sometimes it is defined like, actually, Lord's eyes are more beautiful than the lotus flower. You cannot compare the Lord's eyes with a lotus flower, which is kind of, you know, a fragment of the expression of the Lord's beauty, which is constantly ever flowing in increasing manner by his personal glance. So, when it is said that Ambujaksha, that means a devotee, when he glances the beautiful face of Lord Krishna, and he just looks at the eyes, it's so beautiful, so attractive. He's completely enamored by the beauty of such a beautiful eyes, and he cannot just turn his face away from looking at anything. He cannot just do it, because Lord's eyes are so beautiful. In this material world, just imagine, sometimes you have seen some people, of course, some people, they also have some beautiful eyes in this world, right? We have seen it. This is a fact. Yes, this is a fact. Some people do possess some beautiful eyes. And some other people, they look at their eyes, your eyes are so beautiful. What beauty have you seen? This is material beauty. But there's a toy ambujaksha akra sattva dhamni. The Krishna's beauty, which is emanating from his lotus eye, is ever increasing. There is no end. Krishna expresses many bhavas through his eyes. That actually catches the attention of his devotees. That's how you can see the expression of the beauty of Krishna through his eyes. So beautifully explained in this 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, as we continue, we'll hear. Akhila Sattva Dhamni. He is the shelter of all living entities. Whether in form of Mahavishnu, he is giving shelter to all the conditioned souls at the end of Brahma's life, or the devotees who are constantly engaged in his devotional service while in this material world, or even after going back to Godhead, in all situations, he is giving them shelter. He is the only ashraya for the devotees. That's why the demigods, they are praying, you are Akhila Sattva Dhamni, Jivanam Dhamni Ashraya. You give shelter to everybody. He is such a sweet Lord. Tatpadapotena mahatkritena kurvanti govatsa padam bhavabdhim. Very beautiful point. Srila Prabhupada is making the point in this purport where he is saying that there are some people who are engrossed in the science and they try to continue their life in this material world. There are some others who, by following the path, the process given by the Mahajanas, they continue their life in the material world. So both these people, they are actually happy. They are getting some happiness. Try to understand this. Two people are actually happy in this world, not in between. You cannot be in between to become happy. What is that? One person who is identifying himself with the material nature so much and so that he's always trying to gratify his senses in material association. Yes, he is happy. He is happy in ignorance. He does not know what is waiting for him next. Devotees understand, this guy is suffering like this. His suffering is waiting for him. But an engrossed materialist, he cannot understand the future situation, what is going to happen to him, but in ignorance, he is kind of happy, enjoying this world. And another person is enjoying, who is that?
is a devotee, perfect devotee of the Lord. Who is following Mahatkritena.
This Mahatkritena word, Prabhupada is translating in two different ways. Very interesting actually. See, Prabhupada says, by that action, which is considered the most powerful original existence. In this connection, he is referring to the activities of the Supreme Lord, which is original existence actually. Apart from the pastimes of the Lord, activities of the Lord, anything you see in this material world has got no original existence. They are temporary existence. Only Krishna's pastimes are eternal existence. So, devotees who are in that, you know, like he is proposing Sakhya, Dasya, Vatsalya, Madhur, etc., these rasas, when the devotees are engaged in serving the Lord, then actually these pastimes are very powerful for them. It's original existence. It reveals the original existence of the devotees by coming in contact with such kind of pastimes of the Lord. And then another Prabhupada says, or which is executed by Mahajanas. Very important thing. The Mahatkritena. You cannot just manufacture a whimsical, a concoctive process to serve the Lord or to meditate upon the Lord. No. It has to be given to us by the Mahajanas. Mahajanajena katasrapantha. We have seen Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he writes, he says, Prabhu sanatane parama jatane shikha dila jaha chinta seisava. Oh my dear mind, think of those activities which are taught by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to Sanatana Goswami. When he sings Sanatana means Rupa and Sanatana, you can say. Goswamis means you live by the teachings of the Goswamis. Not that you manufacture your own devotional process and you feel you are progressing, you are successful. No. Mahatkritena. What is the benefit you can ask? Anyway, Krishna says, Je jathamam prapadyante, some may explain like that. No, Je jathamam prapadyante does not mean that you just follow any way you like to follow him. No. Mahatkritena. That path has to be on the line of the acharyas. Again, acharya also bona fide acharya, who is coming on a bona fide disciplic succession. In this connection, we can also say something like, you know, you go, there are so many spiritual, you can say organizations centering around only one person or a society, whatever you may say. And what they are doing? They are just following something what they feel is spiritual practice. But that kind of practice is not helpful. You go to Vrindavan, there are so many people who can tell you how to follow Krishna consciousness, how to become a devotee of Lord Krishna. Think of Krishna in such and such way. No, that is not the process. Process has to be recommended by the acharyas. Prabhu sanatane parama jatane shikha dila jaha chinta seisa. That is our, that's why we say Rupa Anugas. We are followers of Rupa Goswami. We cannot imitate Rupa Goswami, you have to follow. Means what he has said, you just try to practice in that way. Prabhupada has given the process. If we practice the devotional service by following the footsteps of the acharyas, previous acharyas, Goswamis, then what happens? That actually becomes the shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord. When we say, taking shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord, what does it mean? It means you take shelter of the Lord's pastimes, his activities, his glorifications, you meditate, you think about those pastimes and you try to understand it. Fully surrender yourself into practicing the devotional processes which have been given to us by the acharyas. That is what is called taking shelter at the lotus feet of the Lord. Huh? Then that becomes like a poto. Poto means a boat. Tutpada poteno, mahatkriteno. That pada poto, that shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord, which is like a boat, which have been created by the acharyas, mahatkriteno, tutpada poteno, mahatkriteno. Not, you cannot create a boat. Who are you to create a boat? So many people, they keep on giving some kind of, you know, purport to the Vedic literature. Like Prabhupada, he has created a boat, right? Prabhupada's Bhaktivedanta purports are like Tatpada Pota. The proof is, for many, many years, many devotees, by taking shelter of Bhaktivedanta purports, have transcended this material existence. We have seen devotees, just by reading Prabhupada's purport, they lose their taste for material existence. Yes, there are many proofs. Tatpada Potena Mahatkritena, Mahatkritena. This has been created by Mahat, a great devotee of the Lord. And then Kurvanti Govatsa Padam Bhavabdim. Bhavabdim. The ocean of material nescience, material existence, becomes insignificant. Means, when you say, this is insignificant for me, you don't bother about that, you don't care for that, even though it is before you. It's like, you know, it goes unnoticed. That is called not caring for. So, this material existence becomes meaningless for such a devotee who has taken the shelter of the boat which have been created by a Mahajan. So that's what we are trying to explain, that Prabhupada, he has given this Bhaktivedanta purports, and when devotees that read these purports, by reading these purports that take shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord, it automatically puts them in a situation where they lose the taste entirely for material association. Govatsa padam bhavabdim. This entire material existence appears to them just like a calf's hoofprint. Many ways you can explain this. Like, it's very easy to cross a calf's hoofprint, right? It's a small, you know, place like this size. You can just walking, you can just, I mean, very, very easily cross it. Similarly, you can cross this material world without putting any endeavor to it when you take shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord. And another thing, like, how much water contained in a calf's hoofprint? Very little. Means, even up to the Brahmananda, what to speak of the happiness in this material world? Even up to realizing the happiness in Brahman, when compared to that happiness which is contained in a small quantity of water in a calf's hoofprint. So devotees are not enamored at all by such kind of things, even by Brahmanandas. And they, by taking shelter of the Mahatkrita Pota, the boat, the pastimes which have been narrated beautifully by the devotees of the Lord, by taking shelter of such pastimes, they take exclusive shelter at the lotus feet of the Lord, and they enjoy so much and so that entire experience of this material world becomes insignificant to such a devotee. That's why Prabhupada is quoting from Srimad Bhagavatam, he says, Samasritaji padapallava plavam mahat padam punya jasu murare. Bhavam buddhir vatsa padam param padam 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 jad vipadam no tesham. In every step there is danger in this material world. But when you take shelter at Murare, the lotus feet of Murare, the enemy of Mura demon, then you swim in ecstasy. So in that way, this is an information for the devotees that they, by taking shelter at the boat which have been
created by the Mahajanas and they take shelter, exclusive shelter at the lotus feet of the Lord, that's how they can very easily cross this ocean of material existence. The whole entire material creation, material sufferings becomes insignificant to such a devotee. And even though in the material world, sometimes they face with some difficulties, still those difficulties cannot put them into anxiety. They still remain in anxiety and they are fully Krishna conscious. They serve the Lord wholeheartedly, and by executing their life in such a mood, at the end, they go back home, back to Godhead, and they serve the Lord eternally in His eternal spiritual dham. Thank you all very much. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Srila Prabhupada ki, Samaveta Bhaktavrinda ki, Nitai Gaura Premanande, Hare Hare Bol, Hare Bol.